On the last map as well. Oh, that CT pistol. Here's no one to look for the kill. HZ, will he find his fourth opponent to kill? No, he hasn't. And our man in CT is actually quite close to him, just hid behind the wall.
Yeah, and this is just going to completely screw with the mind of no one. He's going to go for the default plant. Should get away with it as well. Only 8 HP. Peeks out here. One shot needed and eventually makes the kill. Nice clutch from no one. They've already got their one round, and now they win a 1v2 clutch.
Yeah, look at that.
They finally got one.
Yeah, and it was no one. Yeah, exactly. It was no one as well, who's kind of in his third opportunity in the clutch situation. Getting desperately outplayed, but... Now
this was very nice.
Yeah, this is super good. And this is just over the top of the smoke. I don't even think he was just not spotted. Maybe Caboose took a shot there or two. But yeah, made a round that was almost lost. Looked competitive. Once again, Ty Lue playing from behind. And now have to save for the maybe the first time. Just in
they do have a UMP though, and we know what that SMG can do.
Oh yeah, force buy, excuse me, but I guess I've just lost a pistol. I guess even this is the first time they've had to force, so.
Yeah, no, they pretty much had
never had to save.
They had bank the whole game. Yeah. The whole of Mirage, they had plenty of money. Captain Mo is going to find the first tech. The thing is, they are very good with these pistols as well. We know that the CZ will come into play at some point, but Breeze, he's got that MAC-10, the candy apple, going to be making himself $600 into the bank already. The push, however, is actually coming out over towards Squeaky, so there is actually some potential for them to find out quite a bit. I'm liking it from the tees, though. They're not going over-aggressive. They didn't run in once they found that kill. They're waiting for the CTs to try and capitalize, try and find a pick themselves. No one will, in fact, catch another trying to push in, and this is much smarter already from Selfless. They're just playing things nice and slow, not over-peaking, and making Ty Lue come to them.
Yeah, it works out. The AK is left in a really awkward spot. I don't know if he's going to be able to escape. It looks like not. That's a big pickup. On a round like this, HZ also in a semi-favorable position, but the door is closed. If someone opens it, this might be a problem, but it looks like he'll be the one to do that. And the two kills are had. Anyways, so no AK saved and retrieved. And Selfless coming with a clean round. Sigh of relief breathed by no one, I think for good reason.
But that's already positive signs. Just the way that they played that round, it definitely didn't look as disjointed as we saw previously. It looked much smarter, sort of controlled. They weren't doing anything too crazy. Obviously, the AK going down was a little bit of a problem, but they rectified it, and they're going to come back into this one against just pistols. Again, a P250 purchase up, a flashbang in play. I always like to see at least one nade come in for a side that is ecoing, so we'll see what they can do with that. And it's looked like they're going to pop flash into a main. They're going to take the map control with all of their players, but there isn't anybody here, and actually they're just waiting outside. This is very, very passive play. Slemmy, he's going to get two. Nice little bit of money made. They've got Nifty as well. He will fall, but other than that, it's only Captain Mo. He's going to try and get himself an extra $300, but he may just be feeding into the Slemmy bank account at this point.
Yeah, and this round's all well and good. Slemmy with a patient shooting. Does get the kill, but it's going to be Ty Lue with... did HC have all the money? Yeah, he pulled the trigger on that armor really quickly. It looked like he was poor, but everybody's got just over 4K, half armor on a couple of players, and some utility. They've got four smokes, which are the key piece of utility. I'd say if you have the rate, what's the most important? It does vary by round and what your strategy is and what side you're on, but in general, smokes are the most useful for killing that timer. On T side for sectioning out of sight, you know, winning a round with zero smokes is infinitely harder than winning a round with just one. They've got the kind of the key ingredients here to win the rounds, or to win this round. But they do have a mountain of a mountain of utility to work against in the hands of Selfless.
That could be much worse than actually first thought, because shooting a player there does actually give away his position just from the sound it makes. So he has actually switched away. If that was tactical, that would be the most mind-blowing thing I've ever seen. But I don't think it was. I think
that
it was just a mistake.
That is three levels deep. Let's not go there.
No, that's like Inception tactics
at
this
point. I'm not
ready. But we are going to see the push coming back towards A main. They still have plenty of time on the clock. Just under a minute. Somebody is going to be taking quite an aggressive peek. Nifty, very quiet in the previous. So was everybody else on the team. But now he's going to go peeking in. Nifty actually playing the bait game. And there's Breeze catching one off. Nice entry onto the site. HZ will be there to trade, so it is back to the 4v4, but they have no utility. Another through the wall, but look at this flank. No one picks up two. Back to a 3v2 advantage over to the T's.
Yeah, super nice late mid there, just the 4-1, very simple CS. to kick this off, and the round isn't quite over yet. Somebody's going to be pushing through.
How is he still alive?
Somebody do a little bit of damage, but not quite enough to pick it up, and this leaves our man DD in a 1v3. He's already in the sight, so he's got a little bit of an opportunity to at least find one person, catch him off guard. We'll spot this boosted player almost certainly. Or will he? Can you not see that?
Oh, I think there might be a little bit of a gap.
He definitely has seen him. He's just waiting. But nobody's given up any kills so far. Might not want to let this man escape. And oh my god.
This is a really smart play from DD. He's trying to bait out as much time as possible. He doesn't have a chance to actually defuse the bomb. Can he actually escape with his life? I think he's just going to go down with the ship by the looks of things. Goes for the push. Can he take the orb out of Nifty's hands? Yes, he can. And he survives. Don't think he's going to be able to retrieve it, but a nice little bit of damage done towards the end of the round.
Okay, this guy's literally Tom Cruise. How the hell did he survive with that low HP? And I don't think he's able to recover the op. They would just get blown away even farther from where he was. But still not a bad round overall. This is not a situation where Selfless have a ton of money left over. They did do a good job on their anti-ecos, and that's why we have a full-on buy here with an op. And, you know, grenades a la carte.
Well, of course, I think Slemmy had a ridiculous amount of money. He got 4 kills in the previous round, 3 with a MAC 10, so not expecting them to be losing too much. Of course, they want to try and keep this one a little bit cleaner. It is mainly pistols in play, and that was one thing the Tyloo were very good at when they were in the lead. They were building up a lot of money because they were keeping the round so very, very clean. Bottle is going to be playing the boost position, not going for anything too aggressive, just waiting to see if the T's are going to try and take a little bit of control. Doesn't look like they are so far, and well, really all we need to see is that one man on B. DD, he's got the rifle, the rest of the players, they're just going to try and stack the A site and see what they can do, and while using the gap, there we go, no one, just going to play that really nicely and make sure no aggression can come in.
Very simple, heavy pressure put on towards A, and there's no one in that position that he would have gone out late mid on a versus a set of rifles. Oh, this is actually, yeah, I have no idea. But that was kind of the similar strategy they used in the previous round. Both their anti-ecos went towards A, 2 up in A main. This time they just kind of moved the round along more quickly. They don't want it to be a tell, the fact that you're doing the same site again at the exact same moment, because if you're not scouting for info, like you have a very passive anti-eco like they did on the previous round, then all that's going to do is stir a rotation from Tyloo. They'll just have 5 people in the site, and you're going to be left to your devices. In that situation, you could have Molotovs and stuff like that. But the cheaper, safer option is just to pick up the pace a little bit. And you know, a lot of times you want to go back to the site that worked. And you can't just do that every single time. And changing how you approach that site or trying to throw a little bit of a different tell without putting somebody on the other side of the map and leaving them in danger can come from just changing up the timing.
A very similar start to what we saw on the previous map. Similar pause time as well. So Tyloo, we'll see if their pause is going to make any difference. Of course, they haven't actually had a 4-by on the board. We haven't seen Captain Mo with the AWP, which now comes into play. And it was an absolute game changer in the previous. Very, very good in many situations.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe reminding anybody who wasn't there for the 16-1 thrashing we saw on the previous map. But a much better start already from Selfless. Got that money rolling. And now we get to see whether it is their T side that really is going to be the one bringing them home on this cash map.
Smoke comes out. Mid control has been secured for very little utility. Now, the clock bleeds down. Selfless is going to have to make a move, but without mid control and having to clear everything out, even if there are no CTs there, it's going to burn the clock quite quickly. Now, they're expecting Tyloo to play extremely aggressively because on CT side, they do play aggressively quite often, but that's kind of a hand or a card that they've shown now. They've gone quite some time without scouting out anything and are kind of forcing themselves and executing a site without any information. Now it seems like they've just moved slowly, but they've actually made some decisions here.
Will be the smoke coming out. We'll block off Captain Mo. Of course, they've lost the A site, well, I think pretty much every single time, so they are going to stick that AWP in position. The smokes have come out. HZ trying to catch somebody over towards the door. 35 seconds left on the clock, but they do have the site to themselves. Nifty will be finding that first entry, and HZ, he's just going to try and get in and deny the plant, but it does not happen. Caboose straight through the smoke, and this is a complete turnaround. Clean up from Selfless. Not losing a single player so far, and Bottle is left just to try and save whatever he can in mid.
Oh, they execute works out really well, and it was kind of a layered execute. They had the first set of smokes come out, because they knew they were going up against a team who was able to hang on to a lot of their utility, they decided to false exec and bait out whatever it is Tai Lu had. And then obviously neutralizing Captain Mo that early on was enormous, right? Nifty winning that duel. And even in that 61, Nifty was hitting all his shots, at least, you know, for the most part. Every time we spectated him, I'm not sure what he ended up with, but he seemed like he was on point, at least from an Opera's perspective. So that is a really big deal. Yes. Favor to the CT, who's sitting there with the op too, right?
Yeah. That's always going to be the factor. And, well, back to pistols once again for Tai Lu, not having anywhere near the same start we saw in the previous map. Maybe it is just going to be that sort of split, each team just dominating the map that they wanted to play. So far, looking pretty damn good for Selfless. They've got themselves 6 rounds, and we were saying how balanced this map can be. Of course, both teams, well, at least from what we've seen so far, looking very, very good on the T side. But now we see what can actually be done with the pistols. Obviously, the CZs, again, as mentioned, have been very effective. DD, one man who can take rounds into its own hands. But I think the big problem as well is just how passive the T side are being, just making it very difficult for any aggression to come out. It is looking like Nifty's going to have a lot of players coming his way, and that's an AWP into the hands of Captain Mo.
Oh no, what a shot. Jesus, a couple of bullets.
Oh, look at
and
this
a headshot,
position.
And he goes unchecked, finds another kill. Damage has been dealt even further, and now there were just 2 players on the T's, and it's actually Slemmy who has less than a quarter of his HP left remaining.
Is going to be pushing, and he's actually going to use his teammate, pushes him with a P250, finds himself another kill. It's all down to 1, and what a shot to finish off the round.
That was Caboose's flash. I was wondering how he got blind, and that flash bounced to, I think, blind whoever might be coming from B main, but because Slemmy looked away from the vent, I think ate it completely. And, you know, he was low HP. You'd probably have your advantage going up against one person coming out of the vent, but the round is probably lost when people with pistols and nothing to lose in the B site end up getting 2.5-3 kills.
Captain Mo definitely not having anywhere near the same impact so far, but he gets himself a free AWP, which is always going to be wonderful for your side. Of course, again, this is looking very, very similar to the previous map. We need to see if Tai Lu can actually sort of break that mold of a couple of trades to start things off. We will lose Caboose, but Slemmy's already found the first pick of the round, bringing it back into a 4v4. Very aggressive from Slemmy, in fact. Has to be a little bit careful, but knows that somebody is slightly isolated, but he does have support.
Yeah, I'm surprised he didn't get instantly mollied out. Rotates have already come in now. Now the trades go 1-for-1, but there it is. No one to get a headshot and finally secure that man advantage. Breeze, I think. I don't know if he spotted DD or if he's just completely aware of this, but looking to win this duel. Oh no, that's a big one. DD coming out ahead by just a hair and staying alive.
Oh, that's it. Goodbye.
There we go.
Burnt down to a crisp. And this leaves it down to just one man. It is Captain Mo in a 1v2. I'm pretty sure he's on something like a 100% win streak at this point in these situations.
100% clutch win rate.
But we will see if it can be the same again. He takes the position but misses the shot, misses a second. And this is not the same Captain Mo that we saw in the previous map. No one's stepping up again, and he's been shutting him down so far in this map.
Yeah, you know, Mo had missed so many, I don't want to be dramatic. He had missed a couple of shots. Yeah, about 3 kind of easy ones, and then ended up on those rounds just like clutching it in insane fashion. So it is weird how spotty his performance was, and yet it was so good when it was most important.
Yeah, interestingly, I think they've realized that as well, and they decided somebody's actually going to pick up the AWP for this round. A little bit of a sketchy buy. Of course, we got a couple of rifles, the AWP, a
Armor
UMP,
USP.
And then, yeah, just a USP, just hoping that somebody drops a gun. DD is going to go aggressive, and they're just getting caught all over the shop at the moment. Selfless, already with the man advantage. Now they're just going to Molotov out, make sure there's nobody else aggressive in that vent, and just play the man advantage. Exactly what Tai Lu was doing to them in the previous map.
Yeah, pretty simply. Now, I mean, they know that Tai Lu in this situation will be hungry for a pick, as any team would be in a 4v5. Further, though, that Tai Lu get very aggressive all the time. And the headshot is good, and offshot missed. Ooh, Nifty, very fortunate to pick up that Glock trade. That could have very easily just been a kill, had no response, and then B main control taken, and off picked up. Ooh, somebody, huge frag.
Tries to get the second, has brought it back to a 3v3. HZ still hasn't managed to find a weapon. The Captain Mo on the other side. No one is going massive at the moment in this map. Gets himself another kill to add to his collection. They've got the B site under their control. HZ will finally find himself a rifle. And this will go back down to a 2v2. Captain Mo got himself a kit in hand, so they do have time to play with. And a low HP Nifty does give them a brilliant opportunity to actually get another round on the board. They really need to get themselves rolling, otherwise Selfless are looking like they may just be able to steamroll this one out of control. One player on the site, the nade will give away his position. Nifty already down, and now HZ tries to find it, but Captain Mo, he's not really in position to actually trade that frag, leaving it back to the 1v1. He does have the kit, going to try and bait out the player. No one, he's going to molly the bomb. That should be the round done and dusted. Captain Mo, there's nothing he can do in this scenario. And once again, he was losing every single clutch. This time, he's going to win it once again. Doesn't get the frag.
Yeah, I got to wonder, though, where on earth was that trade? I mean, his teammate was deep in the site. I mean, he was jumping up. He was shooting two people. And Mo was right behind him in CT. So what exactly was he being sure? I think maybe he was spotting B main, hoping to catch someone on the peak, and then it turned out there was someone in checker, even though the bomb was planted for B main. Good play, though, not to put yourself in a position to have to throw that Molotov from B main and therefore have to peek into line of sight of somebody who knows you're there. So to throw that Molotov over default was quite a good play.
Yep, a rifle at least will be kept, but that is a very, very small glimmer in the distance at this point in time, as Selfless are 8-1 up. They've even got themselves the MAC-10s. Slemmy pulling out their reed just to make them a little bit of extra cash. And, well, maybe. I thought he was actually going to fall down into the Molotov. Mm. Times it quite well. Actually going to get shut down. HZ will be able to get himself a kill. Breeze falling as well to the rifle of Captain Mo, so maybe there is a little bit of potential. We did actually see them do well with the pistols before. That's the only round they've managed to win. But a lovely headshot comes in from Caboose. Somebody doesn't quite manage to connect the final bullet, and now it's Didi. A couple of low players, well, very low, in fact, with Nifty only on 1 HP. And a MAC-10, well, that could be the weapon of choice.
Yeah, maybe a Mo down. I don't know. Obviously, odds are not in his favor. He's got no armor and no kit. And there it is. Footsteps been made. Bomb is starting to get planted. He's literally just going to look for consolation prize in this situation. Caboose, 6-2 is spray. Selfless now 9-1 on T side of cash. So two teams that have been very proficient on T sides. Unfortunately for Selfless, didn't really get a chance to see what they were capable of on this side on Mirage. But Tai Lu not looking like the terror that they were last map. And you know, headsets are off now. We're just having this very talkative time. You can see our Tai Lu manager or coach, excuse me, being very vocal. A lot of hand waving, a lot of hand pointing.
Yeah, well, look at the other side of things.
Oh, we got smiles.
Looking very, very happy. And to be honest, I can see why. This is a complete turnaround from what we saw in the previous map. And I don't, well, the main difference is Captain Mo's not on the map at all. I think he may have only had one, maybe two kills. Really hasn't had any impact. A few situations where he's missed some shots, and he didn't bite him in the last map, but it's really starting to bite him here. Like two missed shots on the same player standing. I think that was Nifty.
Yeah.
Towards headshot, and he should have got that kill. And then sort of in the later situation, we talk about that trade. It's been a couple of bad rounds, so we'll see if they can turn it around now. Nice start. Somebody will be able to find one, but he's quickly traded out. Glass Cannon AWP for Mo. And he's just going to be, look at the retake. They're just playing for retake on that A site. He's very, very passive at this point in time.
Oh, no. Ships in the night here with two players. Well, just kind of walking around the smoke and Slummy getting a critically important headshot. That's the solo man on B, HZ here on the fast rotate, but not able to secure the site. And Slummy looking for another. He has a third kill on the round. Doing so much work by himself. Not a teammate in sight. And he did spot the outline of a player there in event, or not the outline, but he did spot his gun.
It's all down to HZ. Not going to be able to capitalize at all, and a big round coming out from Slemmy, individually taking the B site. And, this is a complete flip. I don't really know. If they like swap sides or something, and one of them just has better PCs,
yeah.
It just seems absolutely insane at this stage that we can see just polar opposites. This is not the first time, but, well, and now we get into a sort of sketchy area. The four spy saga coming out from Tai Lu.
Mm-hmm.
Going to pick themselves up an SMG. two SMGs, a rifle, and a couple of pistols. Nothing really to go on, and the confidence is flowing from Selfless. No one is going to try and line them up. Doesn't manage to knock them down. In fact, it is going to be a couple of trades that come back to give the CTs, well, not only better weaponry, but also a chance to actually win this round.
Yeah, and you know, I don't think Selfless are going to start slacking anytime soon. They've been here before, you know, in a bad way, I want to say. But just like most teams, but maybe a few more times. And that trade not going their way, there's not much they can do about it, but they've still got a bit of an advantage now, the 3v3. Bomb's been planted. Nifty's also in a really great spot. I mean, he can come up whenever he wants. Free kill to be had. Will the trade come out as well? No, HC, no good for it. The UMP on site, that could have been an awkward spot because of
how far away.
Yeah, Nifty was, you know, spotted. He was up on boost. It was exactly how long it took him to get to the site. I don't think the bomb was planted for him, so. Or was it? I'm not sure, but.
Yeah, potential, but it didn't matter in the end. Breeze manages to get the kill, and this is looking like a slaughter going completely the other way. Mm-hmm. I genuinely don't know what Ty Lue could do now. It's like the similar mistakes are being made that we saw on the previous map. Maybe it's just the CT sides of both of these teams are clearly lackluster.
I think that's probably the case. I guess I just would have hoped that if Ty Lue were going to turn up so hard on that first map, it was more them just clicking as a team. But a lot of good things to say, at least about how Selfless has been playing. And I think Mid Control has just worked out so heavily in their favor here on T side, whether it be late or early. And the trade's just going in their favor, or just good trading in general, where they're going one for one, which is favorable, slightly favorable on T side to go one for one. And so their early to mid rounds have turned out really well because of it.
Very lackluster in terms of utility left on the CT side. They don't have a kit, so it's just going to be down to these Angels. It looks like they are just sort of clutching at straws at this point, trying whatever they can to get themselves at least a few rounds on the board. A very, very similar situation to what we saw on the previous map. Going for a little bit of a gamble over towards the A site at the moment. They have gone spotting over towards B, and you can already see the rotation coming out. Yeah, once again, we've already seen this one, so we'll see if they actually bite into it this time. They are going to spot a couple of players, but Captain Mo is down and out for the count already. Another comes in from no one, and this is just almost identical to what we saw previously. One team just running over the other. Slemmy grabs himself another kill, and, well, this leaves it down to just HZ and Bottle. We'll be able to pick up one. But he's just peeking, and I don't even know where Bottle is. He's miles behind the rest of his team, and that's just going to be another round on the ball for Selfless. Mm.
Nice, good stuff. I mean, they used the strategy that worked really well, but they didn't use it too soon after it worked. I mean, they saved it for a bit of time and now bust it out when they really need to just hammer in this final nail. I don't know if these frags matter almost at all. Having the M4 in the next round would be quite nice. Oh. That's one way to go.
Through the wall. No one will be finishing him off. He's had a much, much better game. Slemmy as well, stepping up massively. And
I think they might know that. Yeah, maybe if they had that M4, they would consider it. Or are they actually going to anyway?
Yeah, well, obviously they're on max loss bonus by now. So yeah. They should be able to buy in the next round anyway, even with a UMP or so in play. It is just getting to the point, though, where the pistol can pretty much end the game once more. And worryingly, a lot of the rounds haven't been anywhere near as close, but, well, pistol may be king. HZ starts things off, gets himself a couple of kills. It's quickly traded by Breeze, leaving it down to, once again, just pistols. Nothing else to really play with in this scenario. No one swiftly brings this back to a 3v2. The panic seems to be over, and the bomb could just make its way over towards that B, so obviously they don't know that it's currently clear.
Yeah, they're definitely in comfortable territory now. There's just no chance of a bad half at this point, and if they did give up these last two rounds, it'd be questionable, but it wouldn't really matter, you would think. Still have to go up against Ty Lue on T side and the potential for that pistol. Who knows what would happen in terms of just, I mean, you know, the scoreline was so severe simply because of the second round or the second pistol going the way of Ty Lue, but if Selfless had won that pistol, maybe they at least some, you know, get six or seven rounds and we see a T side and we see, wow, they just had a bad start. Case can be the same for Tyler. You still have the opportunity to win the next pistol. But it is kind of crazy to see this stomp versus stomp. And obviously, looks like it's justified that Tyler or that Selfless picked picks cash.
Yeah, they're looking much, much better, that's for sure. At least the AWP's coming out in this round to pick up a couple of kills for the Tyloo side. It's still going to be a 3v4, and although the bomb is a little bit further back, they have actually abandoned the B site. Only one player holding it down. They will be rotating back in. Can play this as sort of a retake scenario. But as said, the bomb is yet to really move. We still have Slemmy over towards the mid position, sort of waiting to try and catch somebody out on the rotate. The aggression could quite easily be punished. Slemmy goes pushing through, but the timing is not quite there for him. Didi will be able to catch him off, bringing it down to a 4v2. Tyloo just trying to get themselves another round on the board. And well, if they throw this one away, you have to question. Spray through the smoke will actually catch both players a little bit, but not going to get the frag, and the bomb will be able to go down on the B side.
Molotov comes out a little bit prematurely. Won't shy anyone off the plant. Nifty moving over to a more aggressive position because he's got to try to even up here. There's no chance for them to sit on site and win the round. There's one kill. 1v3, is it possible? No, it's not. DD gets the frag, and now two rounds in the half for Tyloo. That is pretty emo.
They've done one better. That is it.
One better.
One better.
200% better.
Yeah, that is a little bit ridiculous, to say the least. But, yeah, going into the second half, safe to say they definitely need the pistol. We saw them win 14 rounds on their last T side. I don't think it's going to be the case this time. Just sheer. Well, it must be so demoralizing.
You just
got to
assume,
back,
you know, they're just, you know, it's the map. They're playing really well, and that's not going to change.
Mm. Also, just the confidence. The plays that are being made, you can just see them hitting every single shot over on the selfless side. Slemmy taking B site on his own. 3v1. He just takes down every single player.
Mm-hmm.
It is just sheer confidence. And the only player that's actually awake at the moment on the Tyloo side is HZ, and he's one of the stand-ins. The three core members that are left have not really had anything to show for themselves.
Yeah.
Captain Mo is nowhere near what he was in the previous map. Somebody, I think, has had maybe one or two moments, but it's... Well, there's only been two rounds,
and yeah,
they won.
Like, what did Mo just do? Like, did he go put lotion on his hands and forget to wash it off or something? I've done that before. That's, you know, that just is a game changer, but you can't assume. That's the case, right? What just happened? Where are we at, Mo? 5-13. I hate calling people out. I never feel good about it. But
wait, it's just the difference. That's all it is. It's because he was so good. If it had just been a sort of more standard way of playing, like you've done, it wouldn't have even been really that questionable. It would just be, okay, he's not playing very well. But after doing so well in the previous map, and then it is basically a different player altogether.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. No one, you know, looking a lot more comfortable now. So yeah, it just kind of hit his stride. And even though Breeze doesn't have that many kills, I think the couple of shots that he has hit looked quite crispy.
Yeah, a lot of, well, every single player at the moment has had their impact, that's for sure. Either way, a little bit of time being given, of course. Tyloo can have a little bit of a talk. I think a lot of this does just go down. If they lose the pistol, they lose the game. That's pretty much guaranteed. But if they win it, well... After I kind of want to say, okay, after I've seen their last T-side.
We can't be sure of anything, right? We just can't. We've seen it all in just a matter of two maps. And like the most extreme examples of what can happen in a game. And there's a question of, would Selfless have done well in the second half if they had won a pistol? Or did we see something that made sense?
Or if they won the knife. Is this what it comes down to?
Does it come down to the knife?
Knife rounds.
It's supposed to be the most infinitesimal...
Yeah. What was it you said at the beginning? The knife round means nothing.
Knife round means absolutely nothing.
Well, the T side is looking.
It can be argued that even on Nuke, the knife round is completely meaningless to a good team who has to play both sides. Yeah, I don't know if that's true anymore. Who knows?
Yeah. Well, if they make the comeback, I will agree with
all
you.
All I can say is thank God I'm not on the analyst desk.
That is true. That is true. I'm glad I can just say what's happening and not actually have to try and predict, because. Mm-hmm. Let's be real. To predict that they would come back in such an insane fashion, it's happened before, but it just doesn't happen very often. Just to come back straight, flat reset, and just go, okay.
I'm going to say it. They come back and win.
What, Tyloo?
Yeah. I think it could happen, and I think it's going to happen.
I don't know. I like sort of playing the numbers.
Yeah, perfect. Good cop, bad cop. You can be.
I'm just looking at those numbers and thinking. How badly would that? Because
it's a bold
even
prediction.
Just a one or two.
What's
like
a
decent
prediction
plays?
without it being? I think there's, you know, this is an unlikely situation, but we have seen that the fact that Tyloo can hit shots right now, just for some reason, in that half of that map, they couldn't.
Yeah, also I think a lot of it was both teams sort of making very, very similar mistakes. Like the entry picks always going to whoever was on the T side. We saw that on both.
Yeah.
Trading wasn't really the case, and isolated very, very easily by smokes.
I'll even say that they have a high likelihood of winning the pistol just based on the fact that they won those last two. They've also just been extremely coordinated on T side, and you know, a lot of it is resting on this round right here. Selfless, no strangers to pistols themselves, but yeah.
I'd hope not.
Let's see. Mo's actually got a molly, which I wonder what it's for.
Yeah. Well, obviously, there's a lot of positions that, like, especially on the A side, it could be utilized, but a lot of the time in pistol rounds, it's used for off the plants. So.
Yeah, that would be a.
Just based on. A lot. Some teams don't buy kits, or if it is, there's only one, so that it makes things a lot easier. Either way,
yeah,
it looks like they're setting up.
Main. Like he's going to be a main late. I don't know if they're going up high with the bomb or if they're going to.
Yeah, they have set up for the boost. So.
See on T pistols, you always want to wait for almost always want to wait for a push if you're not just something doing something right at a spawn, just because CTs will typically push 3B like right off the bat, or they'll. Do some crazy stuff. It got to off if like stack 5 mid or something like that. It's just the rotations are so quick, you can actually afford to do a push like that really easily. Nice shot from Nifty.
Yeah, he got hit by a ding.
Yeah.
How's it be? Breeze in a very, very good position. They're going to go running fast. Actually, both players missing, but it will be Breeze to capitalize back closer. Slemmy, well, he's just got away with it here, and now it is all down to Captain Mo. No armor. Molotov will actually find a kill. I'm not actually sure where that was utilized. It's actually thrown onto the site. And, well, it gets a kill, I suppose that's something, but he's in a 1v3. This is a position that, well, if you'd want anyone, it would be Captain Mo, but let's see if he can try and at least get something. He's completely surrounded. The bomb position is not going to help him out either, but he's going to try and find a pick. Slemmy may even be able to just peek out and find this one out, and the time eventually just goes down, and he has to go for something aggressive.
Yeah. All right, that's never mind. Changed my mind.
You just the final nail has been put in the coffin.
That's yeah. I mean, if we saw the pistol, I thought they had a good chance of winning it. Maybe. And that's kind of sad again. You know, the first map it was sad because we didn't get to see Selfless's T side. Well, now there's very little hope that we get to see Ty lose.
Yeah, very.
And just so many gaps in the data.
Yeah, because the fact is we don't actually know how they would have played the CT side of Mirage. Like, yeah. either team, we don't know how they would have actually performed later on, whether or not Ty Lue would have been much better on the CT side of Mirage, and Cash just isn't working for them with this sort of tag team, but...
Yeah, I mean, is it their own fault? Absolutely, but that doesn't change that.
Yeah. Aggressive push, Slemmy again, same position, he gets away with it once again. Breeze, he's going to be cleaning things up with the help of Slemmy, and that is a complete shutdown round, and that is the second round in a row he's used almost an identical spot.
Very, very powerful with the B main smoke to use that. Snacks does it quite often. And that's just because either people are jumping through smokes or the people in checker have to worry about sight and can't actually clear you too easily. So safe to do it over and over again. The thing is that you just can't be there when the smoke dissipates and have to find somewhere better to be. So as long as they decide to execute it, all that chaos in the utility, and it's fine.
Well, not looking good for seeing that Ty Lue T side. Nifty going to start things off with the scout. It's going to come down to a 5v4 just to try and survive in this map. They have done, as you said, 200% better, but it's not really anything to go on at this stage. 15-2. Somebody will be able to find himself a kill back. HZ actually grabs another. Maybe they're looking for that 300%, although Nifty will trade, bringing it back down to the 2v2. Quite a few low players on the board at the moment. Somebody is going to be rotating back in, but actually they're moving the bomb back towards the B site. Somebody has to connect one of these shots, but the peak will now come out. Somebody still gets away with it, and now it's down to DD versus Nifty.
Okay, place your. I want to know, what do you think? Who's going to win this one?
I'm going to go DD. Why not?
I mean, okay, so Nifty's got 3 kills in this round. They're both very low. I mean, this Famas versus Famas. This is great. Yeah, this is definitely, I mean, this comes down to straight up brains at this point. It's going to be harder for Nifty, no doubt, because the bomb's already been planted. DD's actually gotten to a really good spot, so it depends. Oh, DD's going to actually play this kind of aggressively, too. It seems like he might try to peek. I'm not sure when exactly. and Bomb Splatter mid-site, perfect plant position to make it really confusing as to what exactly is going on. And he's going to peek into that flash. Oh, there it is. You called it.
Woo! it feels like a pretty, well, hollow victory.
Honestly,
at this
I don't
point.
Know. Yeah, it's just for fun, but.
It's a long, long way to go. They have managed to get themselves around on the board with the pistols, but there should be a buyer coming straight back in for the CTs as well. And. Well, they've got so many rounds to play with. All they really need is sort of a cheesy round to just get them through. They're actually not going to invest too much into this. They do have the deeks.
Yeah. I mean, it doesn't... Deagle's 700 bucks. So that's literally, you know, P250, flash, or a lot of things that you can put together. Half armor. I don't know. There's so many things that you can buy with that money. Deagle's quite powerful, but definitely expensive. Almost rarely can afford to put together half armor and a deagle on rounds like these.
Nice little angle for somebody there, but his legs are going to be spotted out. Not going to take too much damage, so it won't be anything that he's really worrying about at this stage. Still playing relatively aggressive with the peaks, especially when he's up against a deagle, but he's going to win the duel anyway. And well, now we're going to see the mid presence come out for the T side. Taking things relatively methodically throughout the map, just taking control, not going for anything overly aggressive, but at the same time, still managing to challenge the majority of the players. Still three players over towards A, so a stack coming into play. DD, well, he's going to remove one of them, spot a second, and this should give leeway that, okay, there's only going to be one over towards the B site, and that's nice and easy take in the end, leaving the remaining two players on A. The bomb will go down on the B site, and this is going to be a simple round for Tyloot.
Definitely an open and shut case here. The deagle comes to play. AK picked up for Caboose. And Slemmy wants one bigger gun for himself as well. Bottle's not going to give it to him, however. And the hunt begins.
Yeah, don't want to let Caboose get away with this rival. But at the same time, don't want to lose too many players. Somebody will eventually finish him off. And they are starting to at least make this look a little bit better, I suppose. Mm-hmm. It's less painful. I wonder... especially on the format as well, when it comes down to these groups, round difference can actually make quite a big difference. So
yeah, that's a good point.
Maybe even just fighting back to, say, 7 or 8 could actually be quite nice for Tyloot just right. In the later format.
You know, but
the
in their
groups.
Group, though, I don't think they're...
yeah.
it's quite a nice group, I'll say that much.
It was a friendly group. Friendly group. Tyloot, and, well, starting things off, talking about 7 or 8 already, Semi is going to put them down to 4 players. He's looking to end this one as soon as possible. Nice start to the round. Still a UMP and a Famas in play on that T side, while we have pretty much the full shebang over on to Selfless. Still looking to go a little bit more aggressive. They want to try and find something out. They don't have much utility, so that is understandable. Trying to capitalize on their man advantage and just basically make it so that they don't have to wait to the later stages of the round, where a retake would be very, very difficult.
Mm-hmm. And again, there were so many rounds on that first map where Selfless had the man advantage and ended up losing it to a heroic play or just great 3v3 from 3v4 from Tyloot. So you have to assume most of the times that those rounds play out that the team who has the advantage will always close them out.
Mm.
And here's a situation where it looks very heavily in favor of Selfless. No one has a great spot right now. He doesn't have to watch Squeaky. He should just be watching for an A main trade. Like, this is a situation where it's like Nifty. Never mind.
Very, very close. Well, actually on scope, and that gives away the position. But it's going to be cleaned up anyway. Caboose quickly takes down the remaining players. And, whoa, what a 16-4 now comes in after the first map.